welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing my mom's makeup tag, Mother's Day edition. And mommy, introduce yourself.
Hi everyone, my name is Terry Medrano. I'm this beautiful girl's mom. This is my firstborn.
Yes.
So we're very proud of her.
So let's jump right in. She already is moisturized. So I'm gonna be priming her face. I'm gonna use a combination of her makeup products that she uses on a daily and mine. I mainly asked her for her foundation, concealer, and brow products because she does not use pomade, and I don't use anything else other than pomade. She has a different skin type than me, so she uses a different primer, and her skin is different from mine. She stays pretty much matte all day, which I don't know why I didn't get that skin, but that's okay. And yeah, so the primer that I'm gonna be using, a combination of the first one is from Bare Minerals. This is just the Prime Time Foundation Primer. Feels a little weird. I didn't even do like the test. Now on the rest of the face, I'm going to be using this Maybelline Master Prime. This is Blur and Illuminate. I'm gonna use this on the rest of her face. So usually I do my eyes first, but I'm gonna be doing her eye color, something she is able to wear all day Mother's Day. Obviously Mother's Day is on a Sunday, so me and my family, we go to church on the regular, so it's not like we're just gonna go because it's Mother's Day, but I don't want her to be looking, you know, I always like to be more toned down, especially when you go to church. So I want her to be glam but neutral at the same time, where she's comfortable to wear it all day. And yeah, so we're gonna start with foundation first. The one that she's gonna be wearing is from It Cosmetics. It's the CC Full Coverage Cream. It's anti-aging and hydrating serum, SPF 50. And I'm just going to spritz her face with some MAC Prep and Prime. You can look. Yeah. Close your eyes. Ah! She's gonna get scared. Hold on.
You can tell I miss a lot of steps when I do my makeup.
I'm just gonna be applying that with a little beauty sponge. One thing I really like about my mom, obviously, because that's honestly one of the main reasons why I love makeup so much, is because ever since I was little, my mom had makeup galore. She actually has this really cool, it's like a purple little
a case kind of?
It's like a makeup case, and then it folds out, but the top portion kind of goes out, and then like she had lip liners and eye pencils all on the top, and then like she had this really cool red lipstick with like that gold little like, it looked like a bullet, but it wasn't a bullet, it was a lipstick. And I literally think I messed it up though one time, but
yeah, it was all your little play stuff.
But that was really cool. But all the makeup that she had, she's always worn makeup, even when I was a baby, and even when my sister was a baby, having two little ones at the same time, because I was four when my sister was born, that did not stop her. She still had her nails did. She still had, you know, a glam face, and she didn't use the excuse of, oh, I have kids, so, you know, I'm not going to do my face. You know, if you, I feel like if you love something before you have kids, why stop just because you have kids? So I think, it's not I think, I know that's one of the main reasons why I love makeup so much. So next for the concealer, she's going to be using the It Bye Bye Concealer. I actually gave her this because when I got it, okay, the color says medium and then it says light medium, but I used it on a couple, well, actually one of my first few videos, and I used it to conceal my brows, and it was, I made it work. But
so much lighter.
I gave it to her. I thought I forgot primer.
No, you did. You did it.
I'm gonna spritz her just a little bit more. Close your eyes.
Much better. That time.
Okay, so with the Morphe R3 brush and the Laura Mercier translucent powder, I am going to just conceal where I put that concealer. And my mom doesn't get oily as much as I do. I really like her skin a lot. And
I like it a lot too right now because it looks like I have Botox.
But I will set her T-zone a little bit, but of course not as much as I can set my T-zone. So, with the excess powder that's from the lid, I'm just going to go over the T-zone.
Wish you could do this for me every day.
One day I will be able to.
I have faith in God you will, sweetie.
And it ended up working out really good because we're filming today on Thursday, which is Feliz Dia de la Madre. So, of course, for my grandma and.
Oh, yes. Your grandma that you highly resemble. That's with us right now.
I know. Our poodle is down there.
My baby.
Next, I'm just going to brush out her brows with a spoolie and the brow product that she uses, she's very fond of this. She's bought it multiple times, so obviously she really loves it. This is the Benefit Goof Proof Brow Pencil. It works really good for, you know, my mom's makeup routine, what she does on a daily, whether, you know, it's something real quick or, you know, she does that extra glam. But, you know, everybody has different likings of makeup. That's the funnest part about makeup. There's not a limit to it. She has her likings. She has, you know, what she prefers. There's products that I use, for instance, the brow pomade, and she just isn't too fond of it. And I prefer a dark brow. She prefers a little bit of a lighter brow. So that's what makes this whole process even better, so.
But I'm at your disposal right now, so.
Then let me use the pomade. No, just kidding.
Oh, I don't know. Next time.
bully. Mm-hmm. That end. Okay, so now that we are done, well, that I'm done with her brows, I'm going to go on to eyeshadow. Of course, I'm gonna stick to, you know, a neutral glam. I'm gonna take my Jesse James Decker palette. For those of you who don't know her, look her up. She does have a YouTube channel. She has a couple of videos. I love her. I'm going to start off. So I'm gonna start off with this color right here, which is Georgia Clay. And I'm just going to be taking this brush right here, which is the Morphe E23 brush. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be putting that into her outer crease with circular motions. And then I'm going to drag that into her inner crease with just windshield wiper motions. And of course, I am going to be building the color to exactly how I want it. Although it is going to be neutral, I do want it to be a little bit extra glam. And I will just adjust the colors and make them more depth to how I want her to look. Like I said, just on the outer corners, circular motions. When you close your eyes, please. When you drag into the inner corner, it'll be windshield wiper motions. So next color I'm gonna be picking up is this color right here, which is called Golden Girl. And it's basically a highlight shade. I'm gonna be using this Morphe R33 brush. And I'm going to go ahead and accentuate her brow bone. Now, I did this step after I started putting her crease color in, just because I do want it to be a little bit of an ombre effect. I don't want the crease color to be on top of that highlight shade. Next palette I'm gonna be taking is my Morphe 24G Grand Glam palette. And I'm gonna be taking this rose gold shade right here. It is shimmer. And I'm just gonna be taking a BH Cosmetics flat brush. And I'm gonna be adding that onto her inner corner. Actually, you can look. On top of that, just a little bit, I'm going to add this shade right here. Just very little. That's just to make the color pop a little bit more. Then what I'm gonna do, this shade right here, it looks very pinkish on camera with the lighting, but it's a neutral pink, it's not too bad. I'm gonna be taking this flat brush from Victoria's Secret and just add that onto the outer lid. What I'm gonna do with this same brush with no additional product, I'm just going to be dragging that out. Into her crease with just small circular motions. I'm just gonna lightly coat her lashes with this Beauty Concepts Gorgeous Lengthening Mascara. So the lashes I'm going to be putting on her are going to be the Zaredo lashes. These are in the style Legendary. And I am going to be using the Duo Brush-On Lash Adhesive. This is the one that dries in clear white, which is always what I prefer. Even if I were to line her eyelid or my eyelid with black eyeliner, I just prefer the glue to dry clear white. I just feel like it works best with any makeup look, not just one particular one. Also, I'll leave a code below. It's Tiana10. If you want to go ahead and purchase these lashes, you do get money off. Close.
This is the only part that I'm letting her do herself because for some reason I just get very anxious and I get very weirded out with applying any type of retractable eyeliner to someone else's upper and lower waterline. I feel like I'm gonna poke them and I definitely don't wanna do that. So
it's okay, sweetie, you do wonderful. Gosh. Can I just sleep like this tonight?
Yes,
and
you may.
Wake up for work tomorrow?
I wanted to listen to the library. Let me do that.
Is that M&M? It is, huh? Where's the lid dog? Oh, right there. Oh. You want awesome 80s? That's all that's on there. Sorry. Well, yeah, there's a little bit of your music, too. There's a little bit of everything. We'll get crazy in a little bit. We might go have a drink after. That's pretty.
Okay, so my mom, she doesn't necessarily contour her face. She actually just uses this. This is the Milani Baked Powder Blush. This is in the color Red Vino. I never know how to say these names.
It's kind of
products.
Iridescent, though.
This is just a mineral powder brush. This is from, I believe this is a Sephora brush, if I'm not mistaken. But
do I want to put my hair back?
Just with a stippling brush, I'm going to go over the color. So next we are going to move on to highlight. I'm showing you these because they're
honeymoon.
They're new. I don't know if you want to use one.
A birthday suit? Mm-hmm. Thank you, doll.
Whatever you want.
It's whatever.
So this highlight is from Star Crush Minerals. This is in Birthday Suit and I'm going to apply it with this B. Bella NG 324 brush. And although this is an eyeshadow brush, I'm just gonna use it today for highlight. I'm just gonna spray it a little bit with some Fix Plus.
My girls always make fun of me because they know I like highlight.
Before highlight was in, she would put highlight everywhere. So technically, my mom was the first one to, one of the first ones. Don't get crazy, everyone. you can apply highlight with whatever you feel is more self-suiting for you. You don't have to apply highlight like this, or you can do your own techniques, of course. Whatever you prefer, whatever works the best for you, then by all means do it. This is just how I'm applying her highlight right now. This is not the way I'm saying you have to do it. I'm gonna be putting highlight a little bit down the bridge of her nose. I'm gonna accentuate her forehead. Yeah. I'm gonna put a tad bit onto her chin. And last but not least, I'm gonna put some on her Cupid's bow. Of course, with any stippling brush of your choice, just go ahead and buff all of that out. Next, before we go into lips, I'm gonna be taking this brow shaping gel just to go ahead and conceal those hairs and wipe off any powder that, of course, got onto them with this whole process.
I'm serious. I'm gonna sleep like this tonight. Like, I don't wanna say in a coffin, but like, I'm Lily Munster. Or
no,
Elvira.
What's her name? In Friday when she's like this.
Oh.
But she does that so her tracks won't slip.
Yeah, Craig's sister, where she's sleeping like.
She's like this, and she's like, oh.
Yeah. That's what I'm gonna do.
Moving on to lipstick, I'm gonna be using Max Rebel.
Speaking of that. Like this.
Rub together, okay? Okay, and on top of that, I'm going to use this ColourPop Karouche collab. This is an ultra satin lip. This is in the color Darling, and this is actually one of my favorites. So I'm just gonna lightly coat that on top. Open just a little bit. Put together. Okay, loves, that is it for this video. This is the finished look, and it's still neutral, but it's glam. She can, you know, wear it all day, of course, and whichever outfit that she chooses, I feel it's gonna go really good. And
thank you, sweetheart.
You're welcome.
My princess.
You're welcome. But yeah, so for all of you mommies out there, I hope you have a very... I'm such a sensitive person. Like, this is not even lying. Like, I can't read cards. I just can't. But,
have a happy.
I hope y'all have a very blessed and happy Mother's Day.
Yes.
You know, I think you should always cherish your mom no matter what. Even though nothing in life is perfect, I still live at home, so I'm still with my mom every day. There's sometimes, you know, where, like anything, you might not agree with something with your mom. Moms always know best, of course. But at the end of the day, everything that she does for me, continues to do for me. I will be 25 next month, and she is just the most amazing person I'll ever know, other than God, of course. And I pray that God blesses me with many more years to come with my mommy. And I, of course, want her to experience the next chapters that I have in life, including my children. I hope God allows her to be there for me and, you know, that next step of my life for a longer period of time. Not just when the time comes when my kids are small. I want her to be there for throughout a, you know, a long duration of my life, so. Anyway, may you all have a very blessed and wonderful day. Enjoy it. Mom should be celebrated all the time, not just one day out of the year. And I love you.
I love you more.
And
happy Mommy's Day, everyone.
Yes.
Spoil your mommies while they're here.
Yes. I love you all. I'll see you all in my next video.
Bye.
Bye.